I suppose you wonder why I've called you all here. I want to identify myself. I'm Ray Bradbury. But you're very curious, aren't you, to find out how I fell in love with books. I learned to read when I was 3 years old. I loved comic strips. I loved the cartoons on Sunday. And I got a book of fairy tales when I was 5 years old. And I fell in love with reading. And when I was six, I saw a film on dinosaurs. And dinosaurs filled my life. A thing that begins when you're 3 and 6 and 10 and 12 winds up in your fictions when you're in your 30s. The things that you do should be things that you love, and things that you love should be things that you do. I was 7 years old when I went to the library for the first time, and I was hoping to find books about the Land of Oz by L. Frank Baum and Tarzan by Edgar Rice Burroughs. That was a great adventure. And I'd open the door of the library and I'd look in and all those people were waiting for me in there. You see, libraries is people. People are waiting in there. Thousands of people who wrote the books. My greatest influences are John Steinbeck. I read The Grapes of Wrath when I was 19 years old. So you find the author who can lead you through the dark. And Shakespeare started me there, and Hamlet started me there, and Richard III, and Emily Dickinson led the way for me, and Edgar Allan Poe said, "This way, here's the light." That's what a library is. So you go into the library and discover yourself. Long at night when I was 12 years old, and I looked at the planet Mars, and I said, "Take me home." And the planet Mars took me home, and I never came back. So I've written every day. In the last 75 years, I've never stopped writing. We should learn from history about the destruction of books. When I was 15 years old, Hitler burned books in the streets of Berlin. So I learned then how dangerous it all was. Because if you didn't have books and the ability to read, you couldn't be part of any civilization. You couldn't be part of a democracy. If you know how to read, you have a complete education about life, then you know how to vote within a democracy. But if you don't know how to read, you don't know how to decide. That's the great thing about our country, is we are a democracy of readers, and we should keep it that way. I published the first version of Fahrenheit in February 1951. When I moved into LA with my family, I had two daughters. I needed an office because my daughters were very loud and wonderful and lovely, but I had no money for an office. I was wandering around up at UCLA, and I heard typing in a room down in the basement. And I went down to the basement, and I found a room with had 12 typewriters in it. I could rent a typewriter for 10 cents a half hour. So I said, "My God, this is my office. Doesn't matter, I was surrounded by students." I got a bag of dimes. I moved into the typing room in the basement of the library, and I spent $9 and $9.80, and I wrote Fahrenheit 451. So you see, what a place for Fahrenheit 451 to be written, in a library of all places where it wasn't being burned. So I made a contract with Valentine, and I went to the library again, where with the typing in the typing room, and I added 25,000 words. How did I do that? I got the characters to come to me. Montag came and said, "Do you know who I am completely?" I said, "No." I said, "Tell me." And the fire chief came to me, and he told me about his prior life. I said to the fire chief, "Why did you burn books?" And he told me. And Clarice McClellan came, who was a 16-year-old girl who was in love with books and libraries and life. Clarice is me. Clarice McClellan is Ray Bradbury, the young boy who fell in love with life. And Clarice is the essence of life and the essence of love. You see, all my characters write the book. I don't write the book. All these characters come to me and say, "Listen to me." And then I listen to them and I put it down, and the book gets written. That's how I write. You see, all these lovers surround me, and they love life, and they tell me about it. At the center of my books is the gift of life. The reason why my books are popular, because they know I'm a lover. When people touch my books, they are alive. So that's the gift I give to them, and I want them to carry them back and forth to the library. Books are smart and brilliant and wise. Love what you do and do what you love. Don't listen to anyone else who tells you not to do it. You do what you want, what you love. But imagination should be the center of your life. Fantasy at the center of your life. I'm going to have a t-shirt made. It says, stand at the top of the cliff and jump off and build your wings on the way down. We are all the sons and the daughters of time. So I thank the universe for making life on Earth and allowing me to come alive here. I want to close up at the cat now.